Hi there. I wanted to make a little video for this slope intercept practice sheet, and this is practice for major assignment one. For this sheet here that I've made up, the first thing you're going to do is enter your name, and then this data here will fill out. Before that, you have no data here. So here I'll put in Richard. Okay, so here's the data that I'm going to use to then do my predictions and plot my scatter plot and stuff. By the way, the instructions are here and here, and everything you fill out is color-coded, the usual thing. You should be sort of familiar with this by now. I'm going to go ahead and put in the scatter plot for this, so I can just I can actually highlight this entire thing, including the X and the Y, and that'll grab me some names. And then I'm going to do insert scatter plot like that, and it's going to come in and stick it in there. Okay, so there's my data shown here. My data is negative value, so it looks kind of funny because the x-axis is on top. Everybody will get something a little bit different here. Decided to name this y. We can change that if we want to later. Let's not worry too much about that right now. What I want to do next is, so one thing you have to do in your major assignment and that you should do here is add a linear regression line. You know, linear might not be right here since this has this funny shape, but still you can just click here on a data point. All of them should sort of get the little highlighting around them. Right click and do add trend line. Okay, and I actually ask you to extend the trend line from -5 to 20. And so to extend that, you come over here. So here's our trend line options. And so currently it goes to 12, right? So 20 would be 8 past 12. So I'm gonna go forward by 8. Okay, and -5, currently it starts at 2. So -5 would be backwards by 7. So I'm gonna go backwards 7. Okay, and you see now this extends the trend line from -5 to 20. Which is good. Let's see. You could, if you want to, show the equation. Okay, now we're not going to actually use this equation for our formula and stuff. We're going to compute that here using a formula, but it's easy to add onto your plot here if you want to. Okay, and then we'll know we get these things right because we should be getting the same numbers here. Okay, so here we'll compute the intercept. By the way, the intercept is where it crosses right there. Right, we can look at that and see it's going to be maybe a little less than 10, maybe, I don't know, 7 or so. And actually it tells us right here it's 6, right? So here we do, equals intercept. And you can just type part of it. You know, Excel shows you how to complete it and hit tab if you want. And it tells you what to do here. So you want to put in the known y's and then the known x's. So the y's are here, so they go first, that's important. And then the x's. Okay, so there's our intercept, 6.0725. See that thing right there. And then we're going to compute the slope. So that formula is slope. And again, you can just type part of it and hit tab. And then same thing, you're going to do the y's first and then the x's. Okay, and I'm just putting the mouse there and dragging over those ranges. That's all I'm doing. Okay, and then here we're going to put the equation. Now the equation is here, right? So we already know what it's supposed to be, but I just want you to type it in for practice. So y equals, and then we're going to have the slope, so -4.8. I'm going to go ahead and just round. Oh, so whoops, -4.8 x plus, and I'm going to round the other one to 6.1. Okay, so there we go. So like that, right? So that would be what we put there, okay? Now we want to put here for formulas is we want to basically put this formula in, but we want to use cell references, of course, to these numbers we computed. So here I'm going to say equals, and then I want the slope, right, times the x value plus the intercept value. That's our formula. Same formula here, right? And now the slope and the intercept, I don't want them to change as I autocomplete. So I'm going to put the little dollar sign there. I put a dollar sign here, okay? And then I can just take this thing and I could just drag it down, but it'll sort of mess up the border. So I'm gonna do copy it, and I'm gonna just highlight these and do paste formula only. So I'm just gonna paste the formula. So there's the corresponding values that are in there, okay? Okay, so the next thing I want you to do here is, and I want you to add the predictions to your scatter plot, okay? So here this is maybe the hardest thing to get right. Let's see, I have some little thing from my recordings in the way. Give me just a second while I hide something that you can't see anyway. There we go. Okay, so what I want to do is I want to click on a piece of the graph, okay? And I want to come up here to design, and then I want to choose select data, okay? And then I'm going to add a data set, namely this one here, so add, okay? And we don't really care what the name is, but if you wanted to, you could click in there and say, use the prediction, that word predictions for the name, okay? And then down here for the X's, right? We're gonna take those guys. Okay, and now this one's kind of important here. You're gonna click in there and erase what's there, okay? And then we're gonna come highlight these guys here. Okay, so now this is just taking the name and then taking the X's, which is that range right there, and then taking the Y's, which is that range right there. And then we're gonna add those, okay? So like that. And you should see they should be exactly on the line right here, right? So this is exactly where they should fall, okay? And then now we wanna use the graph to try to predict value of Y at X equals 18. Okay, and for that, you might need to stretch out your graph some like that so you can see a little bit better. And I'm gonna throw in some arrows here. You don't have to do this. This is just, you're gonna do this by eye, but I wanna make sure you actually know how to read your graph, okay? So let's say 18 is about there. And so it'll come down and hit the graph. It's a little hard to do this with the mouse. It's about there, okay? And then we're gonna put another one to go find the corresponding Y value. So I'm gonna start in there. And then come out over here, right? And we can see where it's hitting the y-axis. It's a little below minus 80, right? That's 100, so there's 20 in here. So let's say that's 5, I'm gonna guess minus 85. Okay, so you're not putting a formula, you're just using the graph to guess. I'm just wanting you to do this to get practice reading the graph and making sure that you make your graph so that it's actually readable, okay? Let's see, the other thing you do here is you need to add chart title, which I erased somehow. And you need to add axis titles. At least for some of them, we ask you to do this. So here I'm gonna just say, I'm just gonna call this X, okay? I'm not gonna be very creative here. I'm gonna call this one Y. And then up here, I'm just gonna call this scatter plot of the data. Okay, and then that's what you're supposed to do. Okay, so that is it for this little video. Thank you.